Hello, aspirants. So, welcome back to the part 17 of our UPSC current affairs, right? So, today we will be dealing with the national parks, different sanctuaries that are in news. So, let us see the content. So, we will be looking at the Katigaon Wildlife Sanctuary. The name itself has Goa. So, this is there in Goa, okay? So, later we will look at the Goa Beel, which has been declared as the Bihar's community reserve. So we will also look what is a community reserve, okay, in this in particular context. Later we will look at the East Antarctic Marine Protected Area, and there is a particular commission related to this Antarctic region. So we will also look about that. And in the Bandhavgarh Forest, there is first elephant colony. Later we will look at the Madam National Park, Wayanad Wildlife Sanctuary, Pakir Tiger Reserve, Malai Madhavishwara Wildlife Sanctuary, ऋषिकुल्या रूकरी कोस्ट. रूकरी इज ए रूकरी का मतलब ये होता है इट्स ए ब्रीडिंग साइट. ओके एंड फाइनली कम्युनिटी रिजर्व एंड स्पेशल टाइगर फोर्स फॉर द जिम कॉर्बेट टाइगर रिजर्व राइट. द फर्स्ट वन कोटीगांव वाइल्ड लाइफ सैंक्चुरी. सो प्लीज डू रिमेंबर फ्रॉम द वर्ड गोवा. ओके सो दिस इज देयर इन गोवा. सो व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज द एक्टिविस्ट द पॉलिटिशियंस देयर आर wanting this particular sanctuary to be declared as a tiger reserve. Okay, so little bit information about this Kotigaon Wildlife Sanctuary. This is has become as wildlife sanctuary in 1968-69, and this is in border of the Goa Karnataka, right? The vegetation here is moist deciduous type with the spread of the semi and evergreen. Okay, so the Bihar gets its first community reserve called as the Goa Beel. So what is Goa Beel? Goa Beel, sorry. So this is a Oxbow Lake. From geography we know that the Oxbow Lake is formed when the course of a river is changed. So when the course of the river is changed, a portion of the past its course will become a type of lake that is called as the Oxbow Lake. So how it is formed? This formed within the rivers of Mahananda, Kankar on one side, that is in the north, and Ganga in the south and east region. Okay, so in 2004 Goa Beel included this Bhagar Beel and Baldia Chaur. Okay, and this has been declared as important bird area in India. So community reserve, it has its backing in Wildlife Amendment Act, okay, in 2002, right? The next topic is about East Antarctic Marine Protected Area. So why this is in news? The Australia and France, they were trying to bring this particular massive ocean sanctuary, okay, into a protected region, but there are speculations that this is not going to happen because opposition from the China and Russia. Okay, so we have one particular commission here. It is called as the Commission for Conservation of Antarctic Marine Life Resources. Okay, so it has already, this particular commission has already given to the two areas as marine protected areas. There are the South Orkney Islands, okay, southern shelf, that is in 2009, and another Ross Sea region. Okay, please look at the geographical region of this sea. Okay, so little bit background information about this commission. So this is established, this is a came under one convention that has taken place in 1982 to protect the Antarctic marine life. Okay, so it was signed by 14 states and has been ratified by 35 states. Please remember, India is part of that. Okay, so its headquarters in Tasmania, which is in Australia. So Bandhavgarh Forest. So we know Bandhavgarh Forest is in Madhya Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh has got its first elephant colony, which is declared in this particular forest, right? So little bit information regarding the Bandhavgarh Forest here. It is has been notified as a national park in 1968, and in 1993 this has become as a tiger reserve. Okay, so Bandhavgarh Tiger Reserve is one of the important tiger reserve, right? And please do remember, in terms of area, Madhya Pradesh has first position, right, in terms of forest area. Next topic is Madhav National Park. Okay, so this is also in Madhya Pradesh. So this is named after Madhavrao Scindia, who is a ruler of Scindia dynasty, okay, of Marathas, right? So it is a combination of dry and dry thorn forest. So So it's a home for different variety of antelopes, right? Like the chinkara, nilgiri, and deer, right? And also, it has carnivores like leopard, wolves, jackal, fox, and wild dogs, etc. The next topic is Wayanad Wildlife Sanctuary. So this is there in the Kerala, and this is the second largest wildlife sanctuary in Kerala. So though it is home for half of the tigers in Kerala, this is not been declared as the tiger reserve. So that's the news. That was the news in current affairs. So it is integral part of the Nilgiri biosphere reserve. So it is bounded by the Nagarhole and Bandipur of the Karnataka, okay, and Mudumalai of the Tamil Nadu. So this is the continuum. This is a continuum of the forest in southern India. So here, let us see little basics. As I said earlier, there was one amendment to the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, which has brought the community reserves, right? So under Wildlife Protection Act, there are four major categories now, which are called as the protection areas, protected areas. That is the wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, community reserves, as we seen in the Bihar, and conservation reserves, right? So these are the four types of protected areas. Pakke Reserve, Pakke Tiger Reserve. So this is in the Arunachal Pradesh. So why it is in news? Because recently Arunachal Pradesh has planning to build one national road passing through this tiger reserve. So almost like nearly 700 kilometers highway. So this is a part of the East-West Industrial Corridor. Okay. So little bit more information regarding the same. This tiger reserve has got the India's Biodiversity Award in 2016. Okay, for the conservation of the threatened species. Here, the Hornbill Nest Adoption Program. Because of that, it has got this particular award. Okay. So little more information regarding the tiger reserve. This is bounded by the Bareilly or the Kameng River. Please remember, Kameng River passes through this in the west and north, and Pakke River, Pakke. So this name has got from this river called as Pakke River, which flows in the east. So the neighbors for this particular reserve is the Pabum Reserve Forest in Arunachal Pradesh, and Assam's Nameri National Park, Doimara Reserve, and the Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. Okay. And there is one other important sanctuary, that is Sesa Orchid Sanctuary in the west of the Kameng River. Okay. So Malay Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary. So this has been notified as the Tiger Reserve. So this is there in Chamarajnagar district. Okay. In this particular district, this sanctuary is there, which is being declared now as a Tiger Reserve. So because of if now this has been declared, so now because of that, this particular district now got a unique identity. What is it? It has the three tiger reserves, right? So it has already got Bandipur, Bilgiri, Ratnagar Temple, tiger reserves, right? And please remember, with this inclusion, Karnataka will have six tiger reserves: Nagarhole, Bhadra, Ashni, Dandeli, apart from Bandipur and BRT tiger reserves, right? And Rishikilya Rookery Coast, as I said, Rookery का मतलब ये होता है, it is a breeding site. So Gahirmata Marine Sanctuary and Rishikilya Rookery Coast in Janjam district are the main No, main spots for the Oriole Ridley nesting sites in Odisha. Okay, so of these sites, Garimata Marine Sanctuary is the largest rookery. Okay, so as I said, it is a mass nesting site for the Olive Ridleys. Please do remember, Olive Ridley is listed as the vulnerable under the IUCN list. Okay, and we will also look at this Olive Ridley in next coming classes, how the government is taking up different actions for promoting the breeding of these species, right? Next is the community reserves. So as I said earlier, so this has its origin in the Amendment Wildlife Protection Act. Okay, so what are these? These are the buffer zones, okay, which are connecting different corridors between the national parks or the wildlife sanctuaries. Okay, So these categories were added because there was increased reduction of the protected areas. Okay, that's the reason this has been included to promote the conservation of the particular species or to conserve the biodiversity of the particular area. The finally, the topic is about the Jim Corbett, which is getting the special tiger force here. See, Uttarakhand government has decided to get this because to check the illegal human intrusion. How? So this is with the surrounding area villages located in and around this area. Okay. Please do remember, this tiger reserve is the first national park in India, and this locates in Shivalik Himalayas and Terai region. Okay. And next is like bird life. So this has been recognized as important bird area. And this extra information regarding this national park. So this is protected and covered under the Wildlife Protection World Wide Fund scheme or program called as the Terai Arc Landscape Program. Okay. So what is this program? This program is intended to protect three of the five key species like the tiger, the Asiatic elephant, and the great one horned rhino. Okay. So. Before ending this topic, I would like to give one tip here. I know it is very much difficult for you to remember many in a national parks and sanctuaries, right? But I will give you one tip here. Is like from the current affairs, what are the sanctuaries that are national parks that are there? Please look at them and their geographical context as well, where they are lying, which rivers are flowing, and what are the important key species that are there, and is there any particular kind of organization associated with that particular national park, and is there any particular program, okay, in the context of current affairs. And overall, if you want to remember the major important these things, please look at the different tiger reserves. Okay, because those are limited, so please do cover all the tiger reserves and look at the nearby national parks and sanctuaries. If you look at those things, I think that information will be enough for you coming down to trickle down to one particular option in MCQs, right? So please do follow this. So let us meet in next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.